No way.
Welcome back, Camily. I'm Carly Selting.
I'm Cambry McNeil.
And I'm Carter Miller.
Yes, yeah. And we just have some Q&A questions today, just to get to know more about us.
Yep.
Okay, so I'm going to start. I'm just going to start with the first one. I feel like we should, like, all answer each one. Okay. So, who would you want to play you in a movie of your life? I would love Emma Watson.
I was gonna actually say her.
Actually?
I don't know. She's got a fun little vibe going for her.
Reese Witherspoon.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I see that.
I don't know. Like, Zendaya.
Oh,
yeah. Scarlett Johansson. My hair is, like, probably
sticking out and it's bothering me.
But my favorite actress is probably Margot Robbie.
Yep. I love her so much.
She could play you, Carly.
Yeah.
Who?
Margot Robbie.
Yeah. She'd be a good one for you, but I think
Reese Witherspoon's like perfect.
Yeah.
I don't know who Margot
Robbie
is.
She's like also
is.
One of my favorites.
She played Barbie in the Barbie movie.
Oh, girl.
I was gonna say, and she's in like The Wolf of Wall Street.
Mm-hmm.
She's really
good. Yeah, I know
good
in that one too.
Mm-hmm. All right.
What's the craziest thing you've ever done in the name of love?
I gotta think about this for a little. Wait, like, you've been so in love with somebody that
you
did
something
crazy?
So crazy.
Like, I don't think I can.
Your love for them. No.
Does it have to be, like, love or, like,
can
it
did
be, like,
it for someone.
Love? Yeah,
love.
It can be, like, love or,
like
love.
You thought you loved.
Okay. So the first time that I ever hung out with this guy, I'd never met him in person before. Like, I've been around him, but, like, I didn't really know who he was. So the first time that we were hanging out, I drove an hour and a half to see him for, like, an hour, and then an hour and a half home, and it was the furthest I've ever driven for a guy. And he ended up sucking in the end, so it was not worth it. But
no, because I have driven 3 hours to spend less time with this man than I was. I had 6 hours total in this car there and back, right? I spent an hour and a half with him.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Who?
Not saying.
No, just like. Just like cover
I'm
your
not
mouth.
Saying.
Oh my gosh, you're telling me after this.
I'm not having a chance to
hear we're catching it.
Okay.
I'll tell you guys
tell
later. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Okay, I'll just say one that I can think of, like, off the top of my head that I'm not scared to say. I went, like, 5 hours away to see him.
Oh.
Because he wanted me to. And then he couldn't even talk to me in front of all of his friends. He had to text me from across the room.
No.
Because he was, like, too scared to talk to me.
That's just the power you have on people, though.
Exactly.
Like, you just, that should just be a confidence booster.
And then I also was walking out of somebody's, like, the big hotel room, whatever, and he was walking in, and I literally ran into him, and I just walked away because I was so mad at him.
That would have too, honestly.
Yeah. Is there anything you wish would come back into fashion? Into fashion? Like, what's a new style that you wish would come back?
So, I really want this.
Okay, so,
back in the day, they used to take their jeans, put a crease, and then they would roll them up, and then they would wear, like, Converse.
Yeah.
And, like, yeah, I want that to come back.
Yeah.
And or else I might just bring it back.
I guess I'm really not super big into fashion.
Neither am I.
So I don't really
look
know.
Look at what I'm wearing.
I know, like, we all look like
I wish. I wish headbands would come, like, more back into fashion. Like, they kind of, sort of are, but, like, I wish I didn't feel like an idiot wearing them because I don't don't have a good hair line. When I like put my hair in a bun, I don't have thick, I don't have thick hair.
Same though. And like my sideburns, I don't like them because they're all different lengths. So
yeah, and plus so sometimes they're just like oopsie.
Yeah.
I wish that I could pull off a headband. Exactly. I feel like my head's such a wonky shape.
Girl,
and
I am
that
an entire
so
tomato-shaped head, but
well,
I still wear
like, I feel like when I do it, like, it just, like, makes my forehead look big, and I kind of feel like I look like,
I think it makes my forehead look
smaller. Yeah,
because
you cover it.
And I cover
like
my little...
I look like a try-hard basketball player. Like, that's what I feel like I look like. Like, I just, like, I look weird.
I look,
Yeah.
You know? And
yeah.
So, I just, like, I don't know.
But not, like, ugly headbands or, like, the thin little ones. Or, like, when people wear pants.
I remember when I used to wear, like, the little Nike, like,
the
like
little tiny
yeah, the
ones.
Little tiny thin ones.
Yeah,
I
I'm
think
not
I
talking
still
about
have what did
not
they even help?
Those.
Like, what did they even
exactly.
do?
They just,
literally
like, made
nothing.
A crease in your head.
Literally.
Yeah. It's, like, it's, like, the today version of a guy wearing a gaming headset for too long and having...
Yeah.
Crease in his head. Have you seen those videos? I saw this guy got a buzz cut. Like,
yeah.
This video game guy, like, got a buzz cut, and his skull was, or his head was literally indented from his headset.
Everybody knows you. Dude.
Yeah, everyone knows. Mr. Wenzel, please cut that out.
He's gonna leave that in, and you ask you to cut it out.
Anyway, he wears that stupid little... when he works.
Oh, his like headset thing?
Yeah.
My dad
oh,
wears
to talk
one of
on the
it's
phone.
It's so funny. I think it's really funny.
What are three things to what three things do you think of the most each day? Like the female Roman Empire type vibe?
Yeah.
Okay. Somebody waiting under my car to stab me at my heels.
Oh. Okay.
Getting kidnapped, but escaping.
Sorry.
And dying in a really weird way.
See, I
like, just, like, the most random way. Like, what if that bookshelf fell on me?
I always think something's gonna come out the toilet. Always.
I always think of, like, one of my loved ones dying. Like, sometimes... Okay, I can't say that because people are gonna be like, what the heck is wrong with you? But sometimes when I'm going to sleep, I, like, imagine people in my life dying, and, like...
Yeah, I do that, too. And then, yeah.
How
yeah.
painful it would
like
be.
Like, how painful
yeah.
it would be, mm-hmm. and, like, how my life would be after that.
What
and,
I'd
like,
work at the funeral.
You guys, I'm actually a really good actress when I'm not in front of anybody. Like, if I'm just alone...
Girl, same.
I can bawl my eyes out on command.
Oh, yeah.
And, like, not even...
When
like,
things have been
I'm
needed,
such a good
and,
actress.
Like, I have to make this lie believable, I will fake cry to my mom at any given time.
Girl, those things.
Any given time. I only have 4 more months until she knows it all.
Fair. Yeah.
Okay.
Not anyway. Even, right?
My birthday is...
So there's January. September, October, November, December.
January.
But we're past the 20th. What day is today?
What
is today? The 27th? Or it's less than 4 months. Like,
excuse me. Anyways.
Like 3 months and 20 days.
If you could choose... To do
you
anything,
you guys. Okay, you said one thing that you think about every day, and you didn't
oh,
say
yeah.
anything. You're supposed to say three things you think about.
Oh, okay.
Well, you said the coming out of the toilet. Then.
The coming
out
of
the
toilet. Yes. Having somebody in my trunk, like I could just be driving down
yeah.
the road, and somebody's like, "Surprise, shot
like somebody's like coming out of your back seat. Like I always.
Yeah.
Leslie said she does this too. Like having to look behind you when you get into your car. You're scared.
Yeah, that is always constantly when I'm driving on roads, I'm like, where's the cow? Where is the cow?
Well, I already said mine about, like, people dying. I also think always about, like, a mouse in my bathroom, like, coming from underneath my little, like, shelf thing in my bathroom. Because
the vanity part?
No, like
where the like
where all my towels
oh.
and stuff are kind of.
Mm-hmm.
Because mice are literally my biggest fear, and in my house when I was little we had like this part, there's like a tiny little hole in the foundation of our house that we didn't know about, and mice would get into our bathroom through that tiny hole.
Mm-hmm. Imagine getting out of the shower. I would go right back in if I saw
one time
mouse
I was literally going
again.
To the bath. I was literally going potty one time, and a mouse crawled out and then just crawled back away, and I literally screamed and I ran out into my kitchen and my pants were pulled down.
I would have done the same.
That's
thing.
How scared I was. They're terrifying. Okay.
Are we ready for the next one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Go ahead.
If you could choose to do anything for a date, what would it be?
Ooh.
I gotta think.
Ride horses.
Horse girl.
I'm just kidding. Out of everything, that's not what I would pick.
Oh. Like
I do love horses.
Yeah. I'd say, like, can I, like, walk you through it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. He picks me up at my house with flowers.
What kind of flowers?
Lilacs and baby's breath.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, baby's breath is always
baby's
have breath
is
in a
so
bouquet.
Pretty. Such a good filler. And he brings a slightly smaller bouquet for my mother. Theirs would be tulips. And whatever else. I don't know.
Just tulips.
Okay. He picks me up. We go out. We go to town. We go to a nice little restaurant. It's like not like expensive nice. It's like cutesy nice. Like almost like a cafe. Okay. Mm-hmm. We get a cute little supper. And then we like go get ice cream. For dessert, I love ice cream. The ice cream does not love me. Okay, you know what I mean. And then we go to like a movie or something. No, we should go mini golfing.
I did that for my birthday.
Really?
Yeah, and then we went to Tuscany.
Oh yeah, you did tell me that. Yeah, and then like ice cream, mini golfing, and then like go home and have like a cute little movie set up. Like real
like
comfy, some popcorns. You have a little projector moment in the living room. Oh, yes. Yes. And a little candy, popcorn.
Yep.
And then, yeah.
Yeah.
That would be my perfect date. Because that just sounds like so, like, thought out. Okay. So, Isaac, if you're watching.
Can I tell you a funny story super quick?
Yeah.
When we went mini golfing on my birthday. There was one hole, I literally couldn't get it. I tried, I was probably on, like, my 20th, whatchamacallit, swing. And these little boys came up behind me and literally were laughing at me, and they were like, she sucks so bad. Like, dude, I can hear you.
I would have cried and then be like, this is your fault.
I literally wanted to whack them over the head with my purple golf club.
You should have.
I should have. They were being so stupid. And it was really annoying. Because I'm, like, not that bad.
No.
Okay.
We believe in you.
Yeah.
And we'll take you mini golfing and we'll be up and
I'm honestly better at, I feel like I'm better at regular golf than mini golf. But I'm not, actually. That's
I'm way
lie.
Better at mini golf than I am because I'm good at putting.
Same.
But,
what's your dream date?
You go first.
Okay. Yeah, same thing as, like, the beginning of what Carter said. Like, he comes and picks me up at my house in his vehicle. But with, like, I like wildflowers. Like, a bouquet of wildflowers, not no basic roses or stuff like that. And then we go, and he has a setup of, like, I don't know how to explain, like, a canopy and a blanket, and then canvases, and we'll just paint, like, paint whatever, and then, because I've always, like, dreamed of, like, movies of, they get in paint fights, and it's literally the cutest thing ever, like, yes, and then, after that whole thing, and we try to be
artists,
whatever, then we can, like, go somewhere else fun or whatever, and then we have to end it in a hot tub because I love hot tubs with chocolate fondue. beside the hot tub.
Not chocolate syrup?
I really hope Kylie doesn't want this.
Sorry, Kylie, I love you.
Chocolate fondue.
I'll tell you the story. Okay.
I remember now.
I love you, Kylie. So much.
I love you too. I don't know, guys. I don't really think about a perfect date very often.
Because you already have so many.
Yeah. I would want to go, like, yeah, I don't know. I was going to say snowboarding, but not for a date, just in general.
You just wanted to.
Yeah.
But yeah, this isn't like your perfect date. Is that if you could do anything, what would you do for a date? Snowboarding. Cuddle up with some hot cocoa.
Yeah, go to like a Christmas tree farm, chop down a tree with my axe.
Oh yeah.
Out. Decorate my little house.
Gingerbread contest.
No, this is actually what I would want to do. I'd want to go to a dog shelter, Humane Society.
Actually, I changed my mind
and
completely.
Pick out a dog, and then like take him to a little park and like take him roaming in the sunflowers.
She wants a date with her dog.
Yeah, I want a date with my dog.
Anyway, my boyfriend I want be there. A rustic cabin date.
Mm-hmm.
With
in
like
Christmas
all that
time.
Yeah, like snow is
like
outside
kind of the vibes
coming
that I
out.
Was
oh yeah, there's
fire.
Hot cocoa, a fire. We can have our canvases and paint in the other room. Like
hot tub while it's snowing.
Yeah,
yeah,
yes.
With little beanies on.
Absolutely. And then we can
chop down that Christmas tree.
Take our skis, and go off.
Oh, sorry.
Like little what
I can't
call
ski.
What?
Yeah.
Like those are the girls ski or is it? No, never mind.
That's
yeah.
I know what you mean.
I know it. I don't.
Anyway,
that's why I whispered it because I didn't want to. What did you want to be when you were little?
I wanted to be a lawyer.
That's cute.
If I thought I could, I definitely would.
It's a lot of stuff.
It's so much. But
I wanted to be a teacher for the longest time. I wanted to be an elementary teacher.
Yeah. When I was like, most of the time when I was young, for a while I wanted to be a vet, but that was when I got older. When I was younger, I wanted to be an acrobat. Like, you know,
yeah, I want to be like an
be
actor.
I wanted to be
when
I
was really
wanted to be like in a carnival. Like, I wanted to be a tightrope walker. Like, I had a little tutu, like green little tutu, and like it was all one piece though.
I want your imagination.
And we had a donkey named Charlie, and like I would like pretend to do like tricks with him, like stand on his back and stuff. And I also wanted to be a princess, which is why I would get in princess dresses and ride my donkey side saddle. And one time he stepped on my brother's face or hand, I don't remember.
Which brother?
Charlie.
Obviously.
But Charlie and I just kept going. We had places to be.
R.I.P. Charlie. What is your biggest complaint about your job?
I love that because
the fact
we
that
all
we're
have
all
the same
yeah.
It's just, I work
I hate
else,
that they keep asking me to come work when I don't want to.
Yeah,
like, I don't care if three people have COVID. I'm busy.
Yeah, masks are back on in our facility.
Yeah.
We just got ours off, like, yesterday. And we're probably going to have to put them back on. But nobody else has to wear them except for the high schoolers. We're the only ones who had to wear them.
Why?
because
the high schoolers are more friendly. Don't be upset.
No, you're not. You're younger.
Supposedly.
And
okay. COVID was blowing up in the high schools only, basically.
Okay, well,
I would definitely have to say some of my coworkers really mm-hmm. make my job freaking hard.
The thing that I hate is when people, it's different if you're calling in like once or twice because you're like actually sick, but if you're calling in
every
when people are expecting that you're going to call in,
then that's bad. And like
when you tell people you're going to purposely call in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah,
or like
literally
you call
just
in
got a text.
Just because you don't want to work with somebody or something, like that drives me nuts. It's like my least favorite thing.
Literally.
There's a lot of things. That
Let
I
me show you
though.
What a text that I just got.
Like,
from.
I love the residents and I love my job.
I love most.
I love my job. There's just like things going on behind.
Let me see.
Oh!
What text?
Oh. You know they still like that.
Yeah, people like that.
Did Kimberly
or like when people
I work on Sunday.
Or like when people complain every time they come to
three
work.
Three different
just, like,
people have COVID.
Yeah, they bring
bad mood,
your negative.
Especially
herb.
When they don't even work that much and they just are already complaining.
Mm-hmm.
That's
well,
me.
Another thing is, like,
I don't ever work, but I still love to complain about it.
If you,
but, like, do you go to work and complain to, like, anybody
oh,
and everybody?
No.
Yeah,
the only person I complain to at work is if Carly's there.
Exactly. Like, I'll complain to, like, Kylie or, like, my mom about it just because, like, I'm tired and, like, I'm just not in the mood to go to work. But when I'm there, like, I'm not sitting there. I'm like, oh, my God, I just want to go home. They hate it.
The only people I do that with is Carly and then Maria, but I think Maria left.
I think so, too.
Cause I think October... What month is it?
September.
Oh.
But another thing
Never
I really,
mind.
Really hate about being a CNA is, like, us being in that facility is what's keeping the facility running. Like,
it's
if you didn't have the CNAs, or even, yeah, us high schoolers kicking a boot in the gear so people actually freaking work, then this facility wouldn't be as high running. It wouldn't have your
wouldn't
residents taking
have
care
as many
of
residents.
But we are the most unappreciated and like talked down on and given the worst time out of everybody in the building. That's what I
hate.
Are you okay, girl?
I don't know if anybody just saw that.
You
but
just
my water splashed back in my face and I went it scared me.
I'm don't cut that out, Mr. Wenzel.
What motivates you? Like, what makes you get out of bed in the morning?
I don't know. Barely anything.
Threats of my mom not paying for things for me anymore. Because, like, she buys me stuff quite frequently. I am her only daughter.
Spoiled.
Maybe a little bit.
You
both
are your mom's only daughters. But I don't have any brothers.
Yeah,
and
but
I
you're
have,
the
like,
youngest.
A
so.
God mound of sisters. Not on my dad, then.
You don't live with your dad.
Dad, I'm sure.
But, yeah, so it's like, I'll be like, oh my gosh, I don't want to go to high school, whatever. Then she'll be like, okay, fine, then you don't really need this, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And she also told me I'm. Have to go to college. I'm not allowed to be a stay-at-home daughter.
A stay-at-home daughter.
Yeah.
That's like probably what motivates me. The fact that I'll be at, like living somewhere else in the air. So I just need
to just gotta get through this. You have this last leg of the race. But I don't know. Probably yeah. The
We've
thought of
been
losing
running for the past 15 years.
Privilege.
And plus, if I like. In bed all day, then just
yeah, it makes your mood just negative automatically, and you're just groggy and
yeah. I wish school started at like 10.
Then
like
I would come and I'd be the sunshine to everybody.
I would so much rather stay 2 hours later.
and come
2 hours earlier. Yeah.
Actually, I don't think I'd like
to. I would.
I would go to
I
school till 5
get
if
out
needed.
At 5:42. That's almost 6 o'clock. Then you have practice until, like, at least 7.
I would
if you're in sports.
Come to school. We come to school at, like, 9:30. Get out at, like, 4:30.
Yeah. Honestly, I'd rather just not come to school at all.
Yeah. But hopefully my college schedule isn't freaking 8 to 4 every day.
I know. I want afternoon classes, but I doubt I'll get it.
Or at least not every day.
But
that's
at least if you have your classes in the morning, they're just, like, done.
Yeah, and then you can,
then
like,
be more productive
work
throughout the day, too, when we sleep in all day.
I would so much rather sleep in all day.
What would you do if you won the lottery? I'd buy a horse.
Quit my job.
Same.
And drop out of school. Buy a house. Invest.
Well, what if I'm gonna, like,
gonna quit school? Still gonna need a lean with.
Yeah, my boyfriend's gonna work and have a
job. Oh, yeah. We got
and
you, Isaac.
Then I can be my stay-at-home mother, which he said I can't be because I have to work. So
imagine if we could go back to the days where you could, like, pay for an entire house, two vehicles, send
I know,
your kids to
I
college
wish
on one income.
Oh yeah,
I
would buy a car
back in the 50s.
I would buy a car and a horse.
Yeah.
No,
you should
I'd
just
buy
a buggy.
Horses, so they have
horse with
each other.
Buggy. Would definitely
or
be
I'd buy a horse
a
and a goat.
Ooh.
House.
I'm too little to buy a house right now. I'd just buy a horse.
Well, technically we'd be 18 because you cannot play with the lottery until you're 18.
Oh, and I'd go buy a lighter because I don't have a lighter in my house.
How are you supposed to light your candles?
Exactly. And we don't even have matches. I'm scared of matches, but I would use it. Whatever. Okay.
I would I'd probably spoil all of my nieces and nephews though too. With all of my
I don't have any nieces and nephews.
Neither do I.
Not yet.
I'll probably be one of the first people.
No,
honestly,
it depends.
I see you kind of being one of the first. Maybe even.
I feel like I'll
not
either
the
I
first,
think I'll be in the top three.
I think so too, because of.
Definitely top three. Yeah, that was one of the
yeah,
things.
Yeah, because
I
my sister broke up with her boyfriend, so.
We didn't want
they're
to
not
say
gonna
it
be first now, even though everybody thought they were.
But she could fall in love with a man in like a year and.
Yeah, Travis Kelce, but he has to break up with Taylor Swift first.
I thought that was like, you're naming a dude that she started to like, and like,
Travis
gonna
Kelce
be juicy deets.
Is actually a football player.
He's won 2 Super Bowls, and he's one of the best running backs in the entire NFL.
That's never gonna make sense. Specifically, Brendan, when I was like, nobody knew who Travis Kelce was until I started dating Taylor Swift.
Yeah,
because I saw
true
on TikTok
no,
that
I
it
knew
makes guys all
I didn't
mad.
Know who he was
so I said that to Brendan, and he was like, that's not even true. He's won 2 Super Bowls and blah, 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 blah.
That's
blah,
because he's a boy and plays a bunch of football.
I know him because of his mom. And she always wears a double jersey because he also has a brother
yeah,
that plays.
Yeah, he has Jason Kelce.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. For a different game. And then they both played in the Super Bowl last year.
Yep.
That's why I know who they are. Anyways, last question. What's your favorite fast food chain?
Qdoba.
Yeah.
Ooh, I do love
but
Qdoba.
I never go wrong with Mickey D's. Never.
True. I'm gonna throw
the thing is about Qdoba is I don't feel awful after I eat it.
Yeah, I kinda feel awful
and it's
after I eat everything.
And it
though
looks appetizing. Like you can like
it's good.
Yeah, I'm gonna put this into my body instead of close your eyes and eat McDonald's and all the food.
I personally prefer Chick-fil-A. I love it. The sauce is my
I
favorite
like their
thing
sauce
ever.
I love that.
That's
never,
literally the only reason is
I've
for the Chick-fil-A sauce.
I've never eaten anything else from there, but I've gotten the sauce from Walmart.
Yeah, it's so good. That's why I love it.
I've
and
their
fries are really
so
good.
It's better.
I get their chicken nuggets. But I want to try, have you guys seen the, like, salad bowl thing with, like, it's basically, it's not like a salad. It's like their fries and their nuggets mixed in with their mac and cheese, like and a bunch of sauces.
They're making that on the menu?
Really?
Oh. I'm asking you, are
Oh,
they?
Girl.
I've just seen that on TikTok.
I am not part of that. No, but I want to try that.
Oh, okay. I also like the Whataburger.
Me too. Yeah, because I know that movie or that place because of Rainfall.
Yeah,
I want to eat at
a. It's like a Texas thing.
A Cane's. Cane's?
Yeah.
I want to eat at a Cane's.
Oh
really
my gosh. Yes.
I just want. I like Whataburger. I've had it one time when I went to Texas with my family, like some of my family. And a bunch of my cousins who live in Texas were like, you have to try it. It's so yummy. So
I
love
Slim Chickens. Have you guys ever had that?
Oh. Uh-huh. They have one in Sioux Falls, and it's...
Oh, God.
Sioux Falls is turning into something scary. There's too many places.
Remember when we ordered crumble cookies at Sioux Falls, and we literally, like, ate them all?
Yeah. I love
that
crumble cookies.
That strawberry one was
so
good.
So good.
That was my favorite.
It's the only reason I'm in Sioux Falls.
And we had chips and queso.
Chips and queso is top tier, the best thing ever.
Yeah,
no
I never ate it until you would always get it.
Yeah,
Adam,
I love cheese.
I know.
Yeah.
It's delicious.
So does my favorite queso ever is the Hatch queso from B Dubs, but you take out the pico de gallo, whatever,
yeah,
and you add in chili. That's so good. Top tier, try it.
Yes, yes, yes. I'm very hungry. We're making Philly cheesesteaks and
next hour.
Yeah, next
super duper
in like 15 minutes.
And I get to like mess that stuff
by
up.
By the way,
so.
Guys.
Mr. Wenzel left his keys in here.
The blood drive is coming up here in like 2 months.
Did Miss Justin say that you could do just platelets?
No, because I don't think our blood drive
does that.
I think it only does whole blood.
Yeah.
And she tried entering me for an appointment, and it said that I can't.
Yeah.
Because obviously.
Cambry is anemic, and Carly, like, seized. So now neither of them can get
she
blood.
She puked water all over the place.
Now
yeah,
I'm
blacked
the
out,
only
puked
one.
Water.
Yeah. I'm the only one here that's donating. But
and then we had to drive home. And
dude, I literally thought I was gonna die on that because I was gonna pass out.
Because you drove me to my car, and then I was like,
I needed water so bad. Is all I remember is I needed water.
But we,
but those lights,
they were awful.
Such a yellow haze, and it looked
like
it was foggy.
It was awful.
It was cold.
The cookies were yummy though.
Yeah, they were homemade. They were really good.
That's at work. One of our nurses, Carla. Like Eli's mom, she likes to make us cookies sometimes.
I love cookies. yes, she does. And last time that Mark was there, that I was there, he fell asleep in your grandma's bed. Like,
yeah,
crawled into her bed in the nursing home and fell asleep.
Really?
We just had his birthday party this past weekend.
Wasn't she married to somebody else before Mark, though?
My grandma?
Mary.
Mary's married to a different Mark.
Oh,
so her
okay.
Mark
that's
lives
the Mark I know.
In Texas,
then.
They're from Texas. Which Mark do you know?
There's a Mark that comes in, and he's always
bald. Yeah, but he's not the bald one, right?
No.
Right, and he looks old.
Yes.
That would be Mark Kleberg, my step grandpa.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mary.
So Paula
was never married before, but my grandma Paula was married to my grandpa Bob. And he died of cancer.
I get it now. Every piece is of the puzzle.
And then she's remarried to Mark.
Okay.
And
so Mary
they go
and Paula are
her.
Both married to Mark.
Right.
Okay. I got it now.
It's Mark Kleberg and Mark Copeland.
I know Mark Kleberg.
Yeah. I was
shout
gonna
out
say,
to Mark Kleberg.
Mark Copeland doesn't live in Texas. He doesn't come here.
Okay. And I knew where it was. All right. That's the end of our questions. Is there anything else we want to talk about?
No. Thank you guys so much for having me.
Thank you for coming and being here.
Okay.
No problem.
Thank you.
Bye.
See you next Thursday.